Hello!
Welcome to our video on analytical techniques.
In this video, we will be taking a closer look on everything related to paper chromatography, which includes the mechanism and applications.
Before we proceed, let's meet the team responsible for making this video. We are from 4K6. My name is Adam Harid.
My name is Amira Kistina.
My name is Puchar Haziman.
And I am Cahaya Shafika. Without further ado, let's start.
Paper chromatography is a technique for separating mixtures in very small samples into its components. These separated components can then be isolated, identified and used for further investigation. This technique is ideal for separating a mixture of macromolecules such as proteins and photosynthetic pigments.
Well, how does it work? So, the mixture is dissolved in a suitable solvent or mobile phase and allowed to pass over a stationary phase. This is known as the porous chromatography paper, which restricts the movement of macromolecules. The basic principle of this technique is that the differences of the macromolecules to the chromatography paper cause the component molecules to move through the pores at different speeds. In this way, all the component molecules in the mixture will become separated.
Okay, so now I'll be guiding you through the 11 steps needed to separate different color pigments found in the chlorophyll complex in green leaves using paper chromatography. First, the chlorophyll is extracted from leaves using acetone. Second, a strip of absorptive paper is used as a stationary phase. Third, the chlorophyll extract is then applied repeatedly to form a fine concentrated spot on the starting line drawn earlier on one edge of the paper. Fourth, the spot is then air dried. Fifth, this chlorophyll spot at end of the chromatography paper is then dipped into a suitable solvent such as petroleum ether. Sixth, the concentrated spot of chlorophyll should stay above the surface of the solvent. Seventh, a boiling tube with a cork stopper is used as a chromatography chamber to trap the solvent vapor. 8. The solvent moves up the chromatography paper by capillary action and passes through the chlorophyll spot. 9. The chlorophyll dissolves in the solvent. 10. Before the solvent front reaches the top end of the chromatography paper, the process is stopped and the chromatogram is air dried. 11. The locations of the color pigments are then determined and marked.
If the substances to be tested are colorless and non-fluorescent even under ultraviolet light, then we'll have to treat the chromatogram with some chemicals. For example, for amino acids, we use ninhydrin. Ninhydrin basically reacts with the amino acids to produce a purple coloration. The intensity and the position of the colored spots indicate the type and also the quantity of the constituent amino acids.
So, the molecules in the mixture can actually be identified by their RF or retardation factor values, whereby the retardation factors is equivalent to the distance traveled by compound divided by the distance traveled by the solvent front. This value can be used as a comparison to identify unknown compounds in a mixture.
So, what Puchar previously presented was an example of the ascending type. We have four other types, which are the descending, ascending-descending, radial, and two-dimensional paper chromatography. The descending technique is a complex setup. This is built due to its time-consuming ability. This develops along the gravity. Thus, there is a force which will make the separation quick and easy. The filter paper is attached to a paper support, and the developing solvent is filled into a chamber. The filter paper is saturated with the stationary phase before it is hung. The mobile phase will gradually move downwards, carrying the spot of the test sample along the paper. The term descending is given because the separation of the chromatogram is taking place towards down. The second one is ascending-descending technique. It is the hybrid of the two techniques, which are ascending and descending. In this technique, the upper part of the ascending chromatography can be folded over a glass rod, allowing the ascending development to change over into the descending after crossing the glass rod. The third one is radial paper, also known as circular paper chromatography. This makes use of radial development. In this technique, a circular filter paper is employed. Then the various materials to be analyzed are placed at the center. After drying the spot, the paper is fixed horizontally on the petri dish, possessing the solvent so that the tongue or the wick. When solvent front has moved through a sufficient large distance, the components get separated in the form of concentric circular zones. The last one is two-dimensional chromatography. In this technique, a square or rectangular paper is used. The sample is applied to one of the corners. The second development is performed at right angle to the direction of the first run. This type of chromatography can be carried out with identical solvent systems in both the directions or by two solvent systems.
Okay, so now we are talking about application of paper chromatography. Paper of chromatography is specially used for separation of mixture having polar and nonpolar compounds. It also for separation of amino acid. It is used to determine organic compounds by chemical in urine, etc.
Now, let's take a look at some real-life examples of the paper chromatography applications. Firstly, is in pathology and forensic science.
Next is in the manufacturing plant. Paper chromatography is used to purify and isolate a chemical needed to make a product.
Thank you.